कर्मण्येवाधिकार से सात्विक, राजसिक एंड तामसिक. सात्विक इज द प्योर स्टेट ऑफ माइंड, प्योर स्टेट ऑफ माइंड विच मीन्स यू डोंट हैव एनी थियरीज, यू डू सेल्फलेस वर्क, यू आर लिविंग फॉर अदर्स. यू आर लिविंग फॉर योरसेल्फ ऑफ कोर्स, बट यू आर लिविंग फॉर अदर्स. यू टेक केयर ऑफ द सोसाइटी. You want to make this creation better. So that state of mind, which is very fine-tuned state of mind, that is called sattvic state of mind. First class. Then the second class, rajasic. All politicians, they are all rajasic. They do good work, but there is a motive behind that. Why they are doing? They know it. They are saying something, they are meaning something. Double talk. So they are good to the society, but inherent motive is their own selfish growth. So that is called rajasic. And then there is tamasic. Tamasic means you have to do nothing with others. You are just spoiling the society. In whatever way you can, you destroy the structure of the society. You will pollute the environment, you will not be friendly with the ecology, you will hate people, you will backbite, you will do many bad things. Not for any selfish reason, but that is your nature. You are doing just like that. The moment you get up in that state of mind, the whole day you are doing those things. And you get a pleasure out of it. So that is called tamasic state of mind. So there are three states of mind: rajasic, sattvic, rajasic, and tamasic. Three states of mind. And we all have those three traits. Sometime, if you study yourself, when you get up and when you go to bed, if you take a paper and write down what you did, you will categorize in these three columns. Oh, this I did, I should not have done that. And this is okay, but this is the best thing. You know, a blind man waiting to cross the road and you are in a hurry, you are already late in going to college or office. You catch his finger and spend some time and facilitate to cross the road for that blind man. That is sattvic state of mind. Otherwise, you will ignore it. You are already late. You are already late in the office. So you will not stop. But if the state of mind is sattvic, you will do this. You will do this. So the karmic philosophy coming out of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, that there are three types of karma also. So whatever we do, the physical action is not important. It is the intent and motive behind that. So whenever I do something, what is my intent and motive to do that thing? That decides the quality of my action. So I shared with you last time the example that I gave $10,000 to the temple as a charity. Good thing. Very good thing. But my motive is the thought, the intent and motive behind this action is to get the name, fame, recognition. That is my motive. But I am giving $10,000. So I did the right thing. But since my state of mind is not pure, I am looking for something, very selfish reason. First of all, $10,000 is not yours. It belongs to the Almighty. We come naked, we go naked. If I go to college, the college is already there. Somebody has already made the college. I didn't make the college. If you learn the music schools are already there. Through your own hard work, you learn, and you are not sharing that beautiful knowledge to the society. But music was already there. You didn't invent the music, right? And so, Bhagavad Gita, I didn't invent Bhagavad Gita. But it became my passion, and I have been sharing those thoughts with you. So, the idea is the thought, the intent and motive behind any action, whatever we do, that will decide the quality of my action. So I should be very watchful what I do. So if there, this sattvic state of mind is a neutral zone, isme paap pun kuch nahi lagta. It is a very transparent. You do good, it's okay. You merge with the goodness, which is the universal quality of the creation. You become a part of the creation. But the other two categories, rajasic and tamasic, those are the Newton's third law. Actions and reactions are equal and opposite. As you sow, so shall you reap. The karmic law is called the law of consequences, the law of responsibility. So if under these two categories, I understand that whatever seed I will sow, the same fruit I will get it. Nobody can change, no guru can change, even God's intervention is not there. It's a law. It's a law written on the stone. As you sow, so shall you reap, under these two categories. So most of us belong to these two categories, most of us. And to be honest, analyze yourself, what we do. If there is a provision on Srimad Bhagavad Gita, I am a little guy. If some big Swamiji come here, and in the next room Shah Rukh Khan comes, what do you think, what will happen? Here there will be two people and that room will be overflowing. It's a state of mind. You don't have to tell people. You yourself will go. He will not drag you. Shah Rukh Khan will not come to you. You will go and sit there because your state of mind is that. And somebody gave the example, I think I shared with you also. Suppose in this room, suppose we are the devotees of Lord Rama, right? So in this room, we put 100 idols, murtis of Lord Rama on these tables. They are made of clay and stone. In the next room, I put 100 statues of Ravana, and they are made of platinum, gold. And I tell the people in the hall, go and pick up, go to the two rooms and pick up whatever you want to pick. Nobody will come here. They will go to that room where Ravana's statue is lying there because they are made of gold. So that is the state of mind. That is the state of mind. But people who understand that I have to be qualitative in my action, in my thoughts, I will come here. Because I have to compromise and let it go the greed part. But if I am not watchful, it's very easy. I will go to that room. I will pick up Lord Ravana's statue, which is made of gold, platinum gold. And all these statues of Lord Rama, which are made of clay, they will be lying here. Nobody will enter this room. But who will do that? The choice was ours. We were told to go to these two rooms and whatever you want to pick, pick. So the majority of the people, believe me, they will not come in this room. They will not come in this room. So who is doing that? I am doing myself. You are doing yourself. Because the state of mind, we are the slave of our mind. But we should be the king of our mind. That is the central message of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. How to be a king of your mind? That is this whole philosophy is. But we human beings are the slave of our mind. Wherever mind directs us, we go there. Bhagavad Gita is a science of discipline. Discipline. Self-education. Self-awareness. Self-realization. That is called Bhagavad Gita. So, as you sow, so shall you reap. The law of responsibility. The law of consequences. Nobody can change that law. Because that is the law of the creation. When you form a company, right? There are rules, do's and don'ts for everybody. Right from top of president, vice president, financial officer, other things, manager, directors. Everybody have assigned duties. And nobody is supposed to break those rules. So if somebody breaks the rule, what happens?
Punishment.
Punishment. So the same concept is applicable. Dharma, as I explained to you, dharma is a value system on which this whole creation was created. And Lord said, the Almighty God who created this creation, phenomenal creation, that these are the rules. Follow it, you are a dharmic. If you don't follow it, you are a dharmic. Does not matter what word you are using. So, do's and don'ts, that is another name of karmic philosophy. But I have to discipline myself. God has given us this beautiful body. Everybody has the same body. Nobody has 10 hearts. Nobody has 20 eyes. Nobody has 50 hands. No. Everybody is compact. And all the emotions are same. All the emotions. You cry the same way, I cry the same way, you laugh the same way, I laugh the same way. But people who understand to make a distinction between right and wrong, they are ahead of the game. They are dharmic people. They are productive people. They are qualitative people. They are society friendly. So, whose responsibility is to become a better man so that the karmic philosophy, he can defy it? Defy in the sense, I should do right things, so the nature will help me. In this world in which we are living, it is only 1% visible world. 99% it is invisible. So there are demon forces and there are divine forces. But both are invisible. So if you do divine things, divine invisible forces help you. If you do demon works, demon forces, evil forces will help you. A person who is shoplifting at Macy's store, if he is not caught, if he defy and defeat the security system, if he is not caught, and he continues, now the evil forces is helping him, after 10 years he becomes a professional. Does not matter what type of security you bring, he knows how to break it. Because evil forces help him. The same way the divinity works. If you start doing good things, divine forces help you. And in time, you will be a divine person. You will talk differently, you will walk differently, your eating habits will be different, your interaction with the society will be different. You will be making people positive, not negative. Positivity is the litmus test of spirituality. If you are negative, you are 1,000 miles away from spirituality. But positivity, you must be positive and then make the people positive. Whenever you talk, interact, make people positive. Don't drag them, don't backbite, don't insult them, don't hurt them through your speech. These are not divine habits. But who has to do it? Me, you, individual. We can help each other. But homework I have to do. I have to do my homework. So, going back to the karmic philosophy. Rajasic and tamasic, these two categories, this brings you to the point of reincarnation. Under this, these two categories, we are the programmers. Now there are a lot of IT people sitting here. So I am using the computer language. We are the programmers at our own level. We write the program on a daily basis, on a certain thing which you cannot see. But you are writing the program. So at the end of the day, when I leave this planet, that profound chip on which I have written the program, for which I was a programmer, it has to be certified by somebody. And that certification comes from Lord Krishna. In chapter 15, Lord Krishna says, I am seated in the heart of everybody. Sarvasya chaham haridhi sannivishto mattaha samritir jnanam pohanam vedai sarvai rahme vedyo vedant kridade avidev chaham. I am seated in the heart of everybody. I am the memory. I am the forgetfulness. If you intuitively hold these thoughts all the time, then there is no need to study Vedas, because this is the gist of Vedas, this is the juice of Vedas. So if Lord Krishna is seated in my heart all the time, what is he doing? In spiritual language, he is called Chitrako. The person who is taking your picture secretly, that designation is called Chitragupt. Gupta roop se kisi ka chitra le lena, usko Chitragupt kehte hain. And he is seated here. So he, jisko aap conscious kehte ho, ki atma ji hume pata chal jata hai, jab hum galat kaam kare ya theek kaam kare, pata to chal jata hai. That is what he is doing. So my programming, which I am writing, and he being the cameraman, he is taking picture of all my activities. It has to be reconciled and certified. And his memory column will override my programming. Because I am selfish, I may be writing wrong programming. And whatever Lord Krishna has photographed, that will go on my chip. And I will carry that chip and I will wait to be reborn in the prospective mother's womb, and that chip will go there. And in time, when that chip starts working, because it has to find the compatibility, when the compatibility develops, then my behavior also changes. If you go to the nursery, 10 different nationalities, newborn babies are there. All are beautiful, all are smiling, all are tender, all are roses. But go there and visit them after 1 year, they're all different. All different. Even brothers are different. Even twins are different. Because everybody has their own chip. And we are waiting for the compatibility. When the compatibility is well, it starts working. So, under these two categories, Rajasic and Tamasic, I am using the revolving door. People die and they come back. People die and they come back. Until they realize, damn it, the message is same. Message is that I must find divinity in your eyes. That you are my reflection. You are my extension. Until and unless I fine-tune my mind to that level, I may have to take 10,000 births again and again and again. And life is not a good experience. Life is suffering. Lord Buddha, when he got the enlightenment under Bodhi tree, he said, life is suffering. But Bhagavad Gita says, no, life is a beauty. Suffering, hell or heaven, it is a concept. There's no physical things, hell and heaven. It is in your mind. You create heaven. You create hell. There's no hell and heaven anywhere. It is all in our mind. You take care of mind, you're okay. But we don't know the technique. We are not disciplined. We don't have the conviction. We don't have the passion. We think it is a, we treat spirituality as a hobby. No. It is the top priority of your life. Once you set this particular trait of your personality intact, all other things fall. Life becomes blessing. These days, in our homes, life is so miserable. People are fighting. Husband and wife are fighting. I shared with you many times that I attended one 50th anniversary of one couple. 50th anniversary. And when they came on the podium, they were still fighting. They didn't understand the meaning of life. They were living together. The same bed, the same kitchen, the same living room, the same house. All resources common. Bank balances are common. Joint. Every property, piece of property is joint. But after 50 years of intense association, they are still fighting. They thought the peace is in the temple. The peace is in the lotus feet of Guruji. The peace is in Himalayas at the bank of river. No. Peace, they lost the golden opportunity. Peace is in the kitchen. Peace in the eyes of your wife. Look at the divinity in the eyes of your wife and vice versa. The state of mind will change and the kitchen will become the heaven. You don't have to go anywhere. I have been sharing with you with utmost humility many times that temples are the social setup. It has nothing to do with spirituality or religion. It is make the society better and intact. Social interaction. That is the purpose of temples. People go there, we do read scriptures, we talk, and then we leave. But the growth is yours. It is your responsibility. Did I get it or didn't I leave it right there? So, what I am sharing with you today, the karmic philosophy is this, it's a law of responsibility. It's a law of consequences. If I understand, I digest at my own level the depth of this philosophy, I will have more time to practice it. We say that, young people say that, oh, we will do, these are the things of retirement. When I retire, I will start doing that. No, we have slave our habits. People have retired, they are having a miserable life. Because they were doing exactly what they are doing before. Because they are the slave of the habits. Retirement is a concept. It will not change your habits. Habits will change if you start practicing on a daily basis. Small thing. Life is made of small things. Big things come once in a while in life. So when I get up and I'm aware, first one is the awareness. Keep the awareness alive that I have to be qualitative. In the corporate world these days, the word is quality. Am I right? Wherever you, if you are not qualitative, you will be sacked, you will be fired, your promotion will be stopped. You got to be qualitative and productive. And they go together, production and quality. Production without quality is a junk. Nobody will buy it. So production with quality, that is what everybody is looking for. If a corporation will, we have spent billions of dollars to establish that, what is wrong to borrow the same idea and start working on us? This is also a corporation. Think that way. This is a corporation. You have to sell it. You have to make the product through your thinking. So hell and heaven, we create. It is the creation of our mind. It is not outside, it is inside. When you are very happy, you have seen that. If you are very happy, does not matter what food is given to you. You enjoy it. But if you are irritated, excited, dejected, if I offer to you the best food, you will kick it off. I don't like it. Isme namak zyada hai, isme chini zyada hai. You start making excuses. Because inside, you are excited and agitated. The same living room, if you are sad, the same living room haunts you. But when you are happy, you are enjoying the same living room. So who is doing that? I am doing that. I am blaming people. Usne mera ye kar diya. Usne mera ye kar diya. No, sir or madam. You did it to yourself. You did it to yourself. So, it's a Bhagavad Gita is an opportunity to understand and reflect back. Am I doing the right thing? If I'm not doing the right thing, then I'm wrong. Does not matter where, which guru you select. These days, everybody is looking for a shortcut. Instead of doing their homework on a daily basis, intelligently, judiciously, they are looking for the shortcut. They are trying to copy and paste. That is what the whole society is doing. But that does not work. It will not work. And it has never been worked. I have to do my homework to get the right thing right way. And it is easy. It is very easy. We make it difficult. Life is easy. Believe me. Life is very easy. But we are so expert in making it so difficult by our own thinking, by our own actions and reactions. So, if Lord Krishna is seated in the heart of everybody, right? So what does it mean? I'm just sharing with you at a very small level. What does it mean? That means everybody is divine. Everybody is divine. So if you respect Lord Krishna, with the same extension of argument, you have to respect everybody, because everybody is divine. But then that is a spiritual presumption. Like in legal, there is a legal presumption that everybody is innocent till you prove guilty. Right? That is the rule of law. This is the rule of spirituality. Everybody is divine. This is spiritual presumption. But that does not make you divine until you do divine work. I have to work on this divinity. I have to develop it and mature it through my own experience, through my own small actions with awareness. Awareness. And it is all cost effective. There is no cost involved. Nobody is asking you anything. No money is being requested to give us. No, it is all free. These days there are a lot of workshops. Even in this, let us say in this class, Bhagavad Gita class, if we say $1,000 per class, everybody will be making notes. Right? Because you have paid $1,000. Right? But when it is free, we don't get it. We don't get it. And that is why they are charging money. That is the reason they are charging money for meditation, for yoga classes. That is the reason, because if you give free, people don't have the regard, the value. The value is missing. But if you are a sincere seeker, it is a free discipline, free information. Spirituality is information. And this is the information age. And if information is free, but it is very valuable, I should hold it. But I am not doing it. I am not doing it. So, who has to do it? Me. Bhakti stays with me. If I have to be qualitative, spiritual, God-fearing, if I want the growth in my life, if I want that when I leave this planet, I should be qualitative, I should work on that. Or, because this is the information. But that information has to be applied. Applied. Bhagavad Gita is applied science. It is not act. It is not in the sky. It is in your household. So, according to the concept of karmic philosophy, whatever we do, we have to pay the price. So, better I do right thing and don't pay the price, otherwise I have to pay the price. Certain penalties and punishments are inflicted right away. If I do something wrong, I am caught, I am punished. But if I beat the system and I am not punished, that becomes a carryover in accounting. When you close the books every year, there are carryovers. Accounts which are not settled, they are carryover. And they will continue to be carried over until you write off. Am I right? Who will write off? Nobody will write off. That becomes the destiny. When we die and we are reborn, we are reincarnated, we have a destiny. This was Sanchit Karam Kehte, Sanchit. Accumulated effect of all my right or wrongs. And that is called destiny. And that works in this mysterious way. So, in the new reincarnation, I may be creating more karmas the same way, but also the destiny will start operating at the right time when it gets the compatibility of the circumstances. This is how it works. And Bhagavad Gita says, it is your responsibility. Discipline yourself, it is free, it is cost effective. Just understand the concept, be aware, and carry it over on a daily basis. Suppose, and this is the practical wisdom of Bhagavad Gita, that you are traveling in a train, right? It is packed. And one old lady gets in. How many, do you think, first of all, when you got the seat, you are already tired. You are totally exhausted. And now that old lady standing next to you, what you will do? But you are tired because office and other things, and now you are going home. You are totally exhausted. Will you offer the seat? But if I am aware that I have to create, this is a divine opportunity, that old lady is standing right next to me, this is my divine opportunity, I should avail of. I will get up. And it will be credit. in the books of my life. But who will do that? Most of us will not get it, I tell you, because you are already exhausted. But if I have the awareness that I have to create a credit in the books of my life, I will get it. And that is what it is. It is the awareness. Awareness. So the most aware I am on a daily basis, there is no cost involved. It is just a state of mind. How I think and what I think, that is what it matters. And there are a lot of opportunities to express that gratitude. When we talk under this philosophy, do we hurt people? We do. Through gossip. Gossip means when the person is not there, you are talking about bad things about that person. Good thing, you always compliment people. Gossip means negative. Are we not doing that? Then how can I be a spiritual person? I may be going to temple for 20 years. Does not matter. It is zero. My spiritual growth is zero. But on a daily basis, if I'm doing certain small things, I'm ahead of the game. So that is what the whole spirituality is. And under the karmic philosophy, it is the awareness. Don't do these things. You will be okay. These are the divine warranties coming out of Lord Krishna. हम छोटी छोटी बातों की गारंटी तो ले लेते हैं, फ्रिज लेते हैं, फ्रिज सीएस की वारंटी हमें बड़ी अच्छी लगती है, 3 years की, 2 years की. But Lord Krishna is giving the divine warranty that if you do these things, you are nearest and dearest to me. What else we want? We have to understand the life in its totality. We come alone naked, we go alone naked. All this mela will disappear. Life is solitary, journey is solitary. Why I don't get it right? You cannot take anything. The richest, the mightiest, the most beautiful, the weakest, the beggar, they all go the same way. Everything is left here. So if that is the writing on the wall, why, what is wrong with me to make this thinking a pivot and start working my thoughts around that pivot? It is not a negative thing. I am not scaring you. It is a positive concept of looking at the life from a different angle. When the light passes, if a beam of light passes through prism, science students are there, right? There must be some, right? When the beam of light passes through the prism, there is a spectrum of 7 colors on the other side, right? The same thing is here. Bhagavad Gita is a prism. When you look through Bhagavad Gita, life is different. 7 colors are there. Rainbow is there. Rainbow of peace, prosperity, good health, quality of life. They are there. But I have to use my thought process. I must look at the right angle. Until and unless I use the prism of Bhagavad Gita, life is miserable. On a daily basis, people don't sleep. And if luckily they go to sleep, and by chance they get up for whatever, for little fraction of a time, if they get up during sleep, they cannot go back to sleep. Is it a life? The eyes are swollen, they become black, they are already tense when they come out of the office, tense when they are coming out of the home. Who is creating that? Bhagavad Gita says there is a better way of life. This is a golden opportunity. This human skeleton, human life, human being, this is the apex point of creation. Perfect. We have five senses. All other creation, either they have four, or three, or two, or one. And we have the capacity, the ability, the resources, the wisdom to create the sixth sense, which is called the eye of Harinath, Jnana Chakshu. This, the seat of memory. Here it is hidden, but we don't know the technique how to activate this resource. We die without even touching this. What a big tragedy. That I have $1 billion and I didn't know that. I continue to do menial jobs. And when I was going to die, somebody said, "Oh, Mr. Kapoor, I got a call from the bank. You have $1 million. I said, "No, it is useless. I'm going." But throughout my life, I didn't know that. I was leading a very menial life, doing small things. We are not doing that. We are not using this resource, untouched. And that is where the yoga and meditation comes. There comes the concept of music also. Through music, at the apex point of music, this is opened up. This is opened up. And you have seen that. Advanced musicians, they are the spiritual masters. They know life inside out through music. So, Bhagavad Gita is a golden trail. I have to open up, I must use the key of wisdom to open this. So under karmic philosophy, going back, this rajasic, tam, I said that rajasic state of mind, most of us, we are in that category. Most of us. So how to develop this art so that we can change the category? First of all, I will give you the hints now quickly. First thing is become positive. Become positive in life. Don't look at the negativity. There are always two things. Either the glass is half full or half empty. It depends the state of your mind, you will use that terminology. If you are positive, you will say the glass is half full. If you are negative, you will say the glass is half empty. The truth is the same, but your state of mind will tell you what words are coming out of your mouth. And it makes a big difference. It makes a big difference. And believe me, when you do these things with awareness, become positive. Become positive. The more positive you are, the more spiritual you are. The more positive you are, the more you will be expressive to give gratitude to the people. When you will eat anything, you will do prayer under this concept of positivity. Because bhojan jo hai, jo ann hai, wo kahan se aa gaya? Wo Ishwar ki kripa se aapke table pada hua hai. Second thing, never forget, never ever forget if something is done good to you by somebody. Always be grateful to that individual. But we are so selfish, momentarily we say thank you, but then we forget. If a person has done 99 good things to you, this is how our mind is working. If a person has done 99% good things to you, and one bad day, he did something unintentionally bad, what we do? We totally forget that he or she did 99% good things to me. It may be a bad day, it may be a bad day for me or bad day for him or her. No, we never escape. We write him off from our book of life, that person. And we use the language, how come you did this to me? I never expected this. This is how the human mind is working. But if I am spiritual, I am positive, I will hold the 99%, not the 1%. All our sufferings are self-inflicted because we don't let go the negative thoughts. 10 years before, somebody said, Mr. Kapoor, you are useless. Don't waste our time. Don't come to this class. I never forget. And who is holding that? Me. Because I am a negative person. It is a negative thought. It is a toxic thought. I should let it go. Nobody wants to keep the acid in him or her pocket. These are acidic thoughts. So under this karmic philosophy, rajasic category, I should be positive. Then I can become sattvic. Otherwise, I will stay in the same category and I will be using the revolving door. I will be reincarnated again and again and again, and the message is still the same. That don't do this. Don't do this. So until I get it right, then my quality of life will change. I will become a different person. Different person. It is my responsibility. Third category is the tamasic. Where we become tamasic, I tell you. When you are very revengeful, when you want to take the revenge from somebody, you are tamasic. State of mind is tamasic. Whatever you will do that day, it will be all tamasic. Jaise doodh ko khatta laga dete, something like that. It is that. But if I have the choice. If I stop it, that this is a bad thought, I should not promote it. You are okay. But I must be aware that it is coming. And it will make me weak. It will make my mind contaminated. And all my actions from that point onward will be not qualitative. It's inferior. Dejected. So, whenever tamasic thoughts comes to our mind, this is the awareness. Be alert. The mind is an organ of our body. Its function is to produce millions of thoughts at any given moment. Now we are sitting here, right? You are listening to me, I am talking to you. I don't know how many things you are thinking. You may be thinking many, many things, but still you are listening to me, right? At least you are pretending you are listening to me. The idea is, it is the function of the mind to produce thoughts. But then above mind is an intellect. It's a screening process. I must use that. What thoughts should go in? What should I hold and what should I let it go? But we are not using the screening process judiciously. Jo gand mand hai, it goes inside. And good thoughts, because there is no capacity to absorb like a sponge, you have to squeeze it. Let the dirty water, dirty thoughts go and make a space for better understanding, better thoughts. We don't do that. We don't do that because our screening process is weak. Intellect is weak. We are not using that at its optimum level. If my screening process is good, that out of 100 thoughts, I will let go only 2 thoughts which are very quality, good thoughts, and 98% I will put it in the garbage and forget. And I will cultivate those 2 good thoughts. But we are not doing that. Everything, the screening process is jammed and everything is going inside. It's like a clog. The flush is clogged. The sink is clogged. We have to use the drain of wisdom to clean it. If you don't clean it, it will stagnate. When you will talk, people say, what is rubbish he or she is talking? So, it is our choice, I am telling you. With awareness, if you do that, mind will produce many thoughts. But I must use this screening process through my intellect. And above, over the intellect, there is one more thing. There is the ego. Ego. Ek hota hai abhiman, ek hai swabhiman. Ek hai self-respect, ek hai ego. And both are different products. Both are emotions, both are very powerful, coming out of our own body. And both are very powerful. Self-respect, you must digest this. Self-respect is, I am divine. Lord Krishna is seated in my heart. This is a divine thing, divine warranty, coming out of Bhagavad Gita, chapter 15, verse 15, that I am divine. This is called self-respect. Logo pata hi nahi hai. Wo apne aap ko galiyan ke dete rehte hain. No, you are divine. Now, once you have the awareness I am divine, I have to do no divine works. That's it. This is called swabhiman, self-respect. Like, you are a vegetarian. You are a vegetarian. And I am forcing you to eat meat. Now it's a question of self-respect. Because Lord Krishna is seated in my heart, he does not like meat, I will not let it go inside because I will use my hand supported here. So that awareness will make you a champ that you are divine. So do start doing divine things, small things. When we use the word divinity, does not mean sky or the space or the ecology or the nebulas and Milky Ways. No, it is small things. Small things. So this awareness that I am divine is a self-respect. But when we pretend what we are and actually we are not, that is called ego. That is called ego. Jo aap hai nahi, lekin aap pretend kar rahe ho, that is called ego. That is the tamasha of ego. I gave you the example that in the office, you are my subordinate. I asked you to write up one assignment. You did a lot of research and you submitted your report to me. I submitted, based upon your report, I submitted my report to my supervisor. But I didn't mention your name. This is called ego. I should recognize that this whole backbone of this report is the research done by this individual. And I am submitting that by adding these memos to that particular piece of information. Recognize people. When we don't do that, it is the result of ego. Because thing which does not belong to you, you want to hold it. this wealth that we give lot of charities, right? Now when the time of charity comes, around, I would say, Thanksgiving Day, we get lot of communication, lot of letters, right? Clothing drive, food drive. So let me understand, what we give when there is a clothing drive, what we give? We do clothing drive? Aapne kabhi donate kiya? Clothing, aapne bhi kiya, sabne kiya? What we give?
What we don't use, what we don't like.
Yeah. But do you think, to whom you are kidding? The thing which you develop, you don't like, you have already used or overused it. That you are treating as a charity? Are you kidding me? Put $1,000 in one of the pockets of this shirt and now look at it, how the charity works. We don't do that. So, this is again a pretension. I think I am doing it a charitable work, but this is the most inferior work I am doing. It is better not to give. But if you are giving, buy new couple of shirts, couple of pants, put it there also. Dissociate yourself from some precious asset of your life. That is called charity. People do a lot of charitable work, they go and touch people's heart. This is also charity what I am doing. With utmost humility I am sharing with you. This is also charity. Nobody is paying you anything. The only mission is to change. This is the charity. You are putting a lot of time, a lot of resources. And you are also investing a lot of time and resources. This is charity. But if somebody is paying me $100 per hour, and then I am talking here, and then I say, I do a lot of charity. Are you kidding? You are paid. Get out of here. Charity is to dissociate yourself from some precious asset of your person. It could be time, money, resources, any asset. Try to do that. Then you will understand how the charity works. How the mind will brighten up under that concept. So, it is all a game of thoughts. How I think, that is what Bhagavad Gita guides us. So, if you hold it that I am divine, Lord Krishna is seated in my heart, he is taking my picture all the time, I will not do bad things. In the office when I am doing, on my desk, in my cubicle when I am working, I will not look over the shoulder that supervisor is looking or not. No! He is the supervisor. He is watching you. So do your work. Go in time. Go in time in the office because he is watching you. Our daily life will change with this awareness. And it is cost effective. You are not buying anything. It is just to adjust this. So, under this third category of karma, which is tamasic, until we change, we are miserable. Not only this life, life after life, until and get it right, that this category is very bad. I have to work on that. I have to go to the second category, and then the first category. But on a daily basis, all the three states of mind, tamasic, rajasic, sattvic, we are working on that. But we don't have the awareness. Whenever you do the best thing, qualitative thing, emotionally best, compliment yourself that this is sattvic quality. I should practice this more. That is what it is. It's a practical wisdom. It's a change. In this changeable world, in this world in which we are living, everything is changing with the speed of light. Our body is changing. All cells are changing. New cells are coming. we are dying every moment, and we are rejuvenated every moment because the cells are coming and going. The whole concept of the whole creation is changing. But we don't change. Our thoughts are in stagnation. Hindi mein ek song hai, Tham gaya pani, jam gayi kai. It is like that. Otherwise, time is a river. If you look at the river and fix your gaze at one point, you are looking at the fresh water all the time. If you fix your gaze at one point in the river and the river is flowing, you are looking at that point the whole freshness of the water. Life is like that. Become fresh. Don't stagnate. And choice is ours. Choice is ours. Karmic philosophy gives you the awareness that these things are like that. It is your choice. Where, which category you want to promote. You could be sattvic, you could be rajasic, you could be tamasic. But every category has the result. But the first category, which is sattvic, it is a neutral zone. Usme na paap lagta hai, na pun lagta hai. See you. So that is what the karmic philosophy is. And the verse which I just narrated, Karmanne Vadikaraste, Lord Krishna says that do your duty in a perfect way with awareness of goodness. If you adopt the right means, the result is always good. If you adopt the corrupt means, even if the result is good, the result is bad. God, Lord Krishna says, do your duties and the end result you give it to me. So which end result you want to give to Lord Krishna? Corrupted one by adopting corrupt means, or honest, rigorous, hard work, judicious selection, promotion, by adopting those means, the result is good. And that result you have to offer to Lord Krishna, not Gandhaman. मंदिर में हम जाते हैं, क्वालिटी जो हम लेके जाते हैं, that is the concept. कर्मण्य वाधिकारस्ते, we adopt the right means. The means have to justify the end, not the other way around. People corrupt way से wealth ले लेते हैं, and then they start giving charity. Are you kidding me? It will not be accepted under this theory, because you adopted the dishonest means. The end result is dishonest. Don't offer it to Lord Krishna. It will not be accepted. You may be thinking that is another tamasha of ego, but because you are not what you are thinking. So adopt the right means under this theory. Corrupt means corrupt result. Right means right result. And that right result, Lord Krishna is saying, give it to me as a prasad. I will accept it. And you are the beneficiary. I will bless you. So, I think with these thoughts, we will not conclude it. So, we share the thought of karmic philosophy, the law of karma, the law of consequences, the law of responsibility. It is up to us how to change it on a daily basis. Don't wait for tomorrow. Change, change and change. That is the rule and the wisdom of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Krishna Baladev ki jai.